everyone, welcome back to our channel startuplanes.com. I'm Namrata and I'm taking interviews of the CEOs and founders of several innovative startups in India. In today's interview, I'll be talking to Mrs. Archana, the founder of Bunkar Sarees. She started her business in the year 2016 with the objective of promoting organic handloom sarees in silk, cotton and various other materials. Now they have an online store which was launched in the year 2018. Bunkar Sarees, as the name suggests, is a company where weaver-made products are showcased and promoted at a large scale. They ship worldwide and serve customers with quality sarees. You want to know more about this business? Let's get into the video.
Hello ma'am, thank you for joining today. I'm Namrata and I'll be taking your interview. But before the interview begins, would you like to introduce yourself to the audience?
Hi, I'm Archana Saraswat. I have done MSc in Organic Chemistry and later on I have done MBA in HR from Ipca University. I started my career from pharmaceuticals and worked in companies like Cipla and Glaxo. And while working there only, I was having something in my mind to start some business. And I am the owner and founder of Bunkar Sarees, which is a one-stop destination for handloom sarees. We are catering our customers to our offline store at Lucknow and the online store, that is www.bunkarsarees.com.
All right. So tell me something about your startup. Like, how did you come up with the idea of it?
See, as I told you, I was working in pharmaceuticals and there I used to attend so many meetings and all, and I always used to look forward for Indian attire, that is sarees, and that will be handloom because they look quite presentable during meetings and all. And that time during my search, I found that these handloom products, they are out of the reach of a mediocre person, and secondly, they are very less available in the market. So since then only, because of personal experience, I thought I should work on this field. And secondly, I was working in pharmaceuticals and many companies for the unknown people. So sitting on the other side of the table was also in my mind. So I thought I should work in this field.
All right. Now, was there an existing market gap that you could identify in the field that you're in?
I say existing market is always there for any business. Market is there. So there also, that time also, I just found the gap between the demand and the supply and the pocket and the availability. So that was one thing where it has given me a boost to start this business.
All right. Now, were there any difficulties or challenges you had faced on the initial days?
Initially, raising funds, finding right weavers, procuring raw materials, traveling to every corners and nooks of the country was really a challenge for me. And later on, when I started my business, that time only demonetization was always there, already there. And it slowly crossed, and later on this pandemic came. So the tough time is presently also, we are surviving in tough time only. And there's so many challenges in a startup business, and I'm facing since very beginning only. But we are doing well.
All right. Now, if you had to explain your business model to someone who had very limited knowledge about it, how would you do that?
This business is very simple. Firstly, though, what I do is we procure the raw material and give it to our weavers. They design things according to my choice, my colors, and enhancement of the designs is always there. And secondly, the quality assurance has to be there. This is one thing, and then we just cater to our customers who are handloom lovers who want to wear these comfortable outfits, because there are people who wear sarees whole day, and there this handloom comes. Our business model is this only: we just procure each and everything from our side to maintain the quality, and then we just launch this product to the market, that is our offline and online store.
All right. Now, what are the products you are right now offering?
As India is a country where variety are too much. Each and every state has its own clothes, own design, own stuff, depending on the climatic conditions. So in Bunpur Sarees, what I want to do, I'm trying to do is to keep the things available under one umbrella. First, and I'll tell you one thing, when I started my store in Lucknow, with the name of Bunpur Sarees, firstly, the name was not very catchy. So people were just coming to inquire, what is this Bunpur? Even a Hindi name is also not, the people were not able to understand this. And secondly, they used to come to me कि मुझे ये कांजीवरम कैसा होता है मुझे feel करना है कि बालूचरी कैसा होता है मुझे feel करना है. So there these ideas kicked me. You see, in our country only, our stuff only, people are not able to just feel the things because of the non-availability of the product as well as the price of the product. So there, I'm trying to just bridge the gap between all these things.
All right. Now, who are your target customers? Is it just grown-up women, or you're catering to young girls who are also like starting to wear sarees?
See, nowadays, my target customers is entire universe, I can say, because saree is one outfit which is very elegant, very smart, and each and every class look beautiful in this, right? Secondly, nowadays, overseas demand also has grown up for sarees. All these celebrities, they wear sarees only, and that will be handlooms when they attend any conferences, any shows, and all these things. So I have my target customers each and everywhere. Nowadays, in some shows, males are also wearing sarees. So I have, they are also my target customers. And secondly, there are sometimes people come for their child sarees also. They say, ki bhai, bachi ke liye bhi saree chahiye. So saree is one thing which has no boundaries. I don't think so, okay, there is any boundaries. Along with sarees, as we keep dress materials also in handloom, so that also has a big viability for us.
All right. Now, we all know that there are already brands doing the same thing as you are doing, right? So what makes your products or your company different, or makes your identity stand out amongst the others?
See, as you very rightly said, there are many brands who are dealing in handloom sarees. There's no question about it. When I started my journey in this, I searched a lot about these things, and I have seen that the big brands are there and they are out of pocket. So firstly, so in my company, that is Bunpur Sarees, what we do is we maintain quality. Quality is one thing when customer will come back to you. Quality, authenticity, and trust. And also we take care of the pocket of the customer. So this is how it goes.
Okay. Now, the next question will be like, if anybody wants to join your team and work with you, what kind of work environment is that person is going to get from you?
See, as I told you, I am a person of science background. I worked in pharmaceuticals, I've done MBA in HR, and I'm working in textiles. Right. The same thing happens with my employees also. They get good salary, nice environment, and new things to learn. Because nowadays, things have changed. Each and every person has to learn every day. Like I learn from my vendors, from my bunkers. Many times bunkers tell me, Didi, ye aise achha nahi lagega, ye aise achha lagega. Then staff also tells a lot of things. So for all candidates, for all employees who are working with me or want to work with me, they are going to learn new things. And they are going to be equipped with many intelligences which is going to help them in future.
All right. Now that you're talking about the vendors part, I want to know from you that when selecting vendors, what are the kind of parameters you judge them before being associated with them?
See, firstly, we check the samples of the person, background of the person, samples of the person, and the market sample. There are many things people, they are working on it and this is not in demand. So definitely in today's market scenario, which is very dynamic, we cannot go for those vendors. Presently, the dynamic things are much in popularization. So we work on with those vendors who are good in skills, who can complete the orders on time, and they work according to our parameters and keeping the quality intact. That is fine.
Okay. Now talking about the future of the company, what are the plans you have in mind?
The brand is Bunpur. I can tell you varieties of the sarees. Like we have southern sarees, south sarees, this is Kanjivaram, we have Balichari, we have Kantha, we have Banarsi, we have Chanderi, and there are so many cottons, linen, And there are many people who are associated with us, who are vendors also, who are our customers also, and weavers also. So these are the brand is one only. That is, all these varieties are under one umbrella. That is Gunprasad.
Okay. Now, in the first question only, you had answered that procuring funds or raising funds was an integral or a challenge for you. So if I may ask that, have you taken funds previously or are you willing to in the near future? How is it working for you?
I haven't taken any funds from any outside vendor, but yes, now I'm feeling it. I should take some to promote the business. Procuring raw materials, nowadays things are a little bit difficult. And we are looking for the vendors who can help us in promoting our products and our business.
Lastly, what are your thoughts on Startup Lanes?
Startup Lanes is doing a very good job for promoting young entrepreneurs, for promoting new businesses and keeping us visible for the society. I really thank all the whole startup team to help us. Or everybody you all are helping. It's a great job you are doing. Keeping us visible, our business visible, and our thoughts to the society. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you for your kind words, ma'am. It was lovely talking to you. Thank you for taking out your time and speaking about your business ideas on our platform. It's a pleasure from my side as well as from my team.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thanks a lot.